A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th Feb, on the front page you have Pakistan will hit back if India strikes, says Imran. So this is Pakistan Prime Minister speaking on India's threats that punitive military action would be taken against it. So when such statements are being made, the Pakistan Prime Minister has responded in the context of Pulwama terror attack and has warned India that Islamabad, that is Pakistan, would also retaliate if India thinks of taking any punitive military action. So there are talks of airstrike as such in Pakistan, terrorists spots. Still, they are just talks, and here you can see the response of Pakistan Prime Minister to this. The Pakistan claims that there is no evidence of Pakistan's involvement in the Pulwama attack. So though Jaish-e-Mohammed is involved, it's a terrorist organization, but direct Pakistan's involvement, there is no evidence. Also, they say we ourselves are victim of terrorism. Also, he says that if India provided Pakistan with actionable intelligence about Pakistani involvement in the Pulwama attack, he says, I guarantee action. So this is also a statement being given. Then India, he suggested, should embrace a new thought process and introspect why young people in Kashmir were no longer scared of death. Then this is another accident which has happened. Two aircrafts of Indian Air Force's aerobatic team, Surya Kiran, crashed after grazing each other mid-air during a rehearsal for Aero India show near Bengaluru. The pilot was killed and two others who ejected were injured. You can see how this incident has happened. The two Hawk trainer aircrafts which were rehearsing, and then while grazing each other during the maneuver, they crashed and the aircraft burst into flames after hitting the ground. Then below you have Supreme Court upset at the plight of illegal migrants in Assam centers. So this is regarding illegal immigrants. The foreigners in Assam, they are put in detention centers. So these detention centers are present in Assam. Already in Assam, you're seeing the NRC exercise, National Register of Citizens, exercise, which is going on, the updation of NRC. So here the detention centers exist and illegal migrants are put in them. There are these foreigners tribunals in Assam which give their ruling. When a person is declared as a foreigner, they are put in detention centers. And once their nation from which they have come, if they approve and they accept the migrant, then that person is deported. This presently a case has been filed in the Supreme Court on the plight of these illegal migrants in Assam centers. So that has been heard, that how they live in dismal living conditions in these detention centers. Earlier too, it was in news how the children and the adults were kept separate. So families were separated. A similar case as in USA when it had come, how for illegal migrants there was separation. Family separation. So steps were taken in USA as well as in India on this matter. Steps were taken to ensure that families are not separated behind bars. Then below you have Cabinet approves new national electronics policy. So this is National Electronics Policy 2019, which has been approved by the Union Cabinet. It aims to achieve a turnover of $400 billion for the electronic system design and manufacturing sector by 2025. So, of course, it would generate employment opportunities, which is set to generate employment opportunities for 1 crore people. So, it is to enable flow of investment, technology, and higher value addition in domestic manufacturing of electronics products. So, that is the objective of this national electronics policy. So, there are incentive schemes under it too. So, easier to implement incentive schemes are proposed, like interest subvention scheme, credit default guarantee scheme, which would replace the existing schemes under the National Electronics Policy of 2012. So, this has been proposed. So, there are other important provisions also in this, like the scheme, the National Electronics Policy 2019 also proposes this interest subsidy of 4% on loans up to 1,000 crore on plant and machinery. Then there is another scheme for providing credit guarantee. So, that is also shown here, you can see. So, this will be to provide default guarantee up to 75% to banks for plants and machine loans up to rupees 1,000. rupees 100 crores. So this is there. So the subsidy would be limited to 1000 crores for these plants, and here it is up to 100 crores, the default guarantee. Then there is also plan for creating an ecosystem for the policy to be implemented, that is manufacturing cluster scheme. So this electronics manufacturing cluster scheme, under which infrastructure support will be provided for group of industries that are part of the product supply chain rather than individual industries, would be undertaken. Also a sovereign patent fund would be set up to acquire intellectual property for chips and chip components. On page 7 you have 7 islands in Andaman's Lakshadweep identified for seaplane operations. So bids have been invited for private sector participation in tourism based projects. So this is proposed here, you can see the detail as such given. So connecting the islands. So the center has taken up various projects for development of these islands. So one is the seaplane operation, which has been spoken of. So islands in Andamans, the Swaraj Dweep, Shahid Dweep, Hadpe and Long Island. So these are the ones which have been identified. And in Lakshadweep, Kavaratti, Agatti and Minicoy are the islands identified for seaplane operation. Then other key infrastructure projects in the islands are operationalization of Diglipur Airport in Andamans for civilian aircraft, construction of new airport at Minicoy in Andamans, Middle Strait Bridge on Andaman Trunk Road. So projects identified for private sector participation are ecotourism project on Smith Island and Long Island in Andamans, tent city on Aves Island, and tourism projects at Kadmat, Minicoy and Suheli, Cheriakkara in Lakshadweep. These are the proposals for developing tourism based projects with even private sector participation in Andamans and Lakshadweep, the islands of the country. Then below you have more than 4 lakh children are inhalant addicts survey. So this is a survey conducted by National Drug Dependence Treatment Center of AIIMS, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, in which it has been found that some states are forerunners in alcohol abuse and health complications arising due to addiction. So this is the report which has been submitted to Union Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So it says 5.7 crore people in the country suffer from alcohol related problems. And it is said of the 16 crore people who consumed alcohol across the country, prevalence of alcohol consumption was 17 times higher among men than among women. And more than 4 lakh children and 18 lakh adults also needed help for inhalant abuse and dependence. So this is the figure which has been given regarding, abuse as such. This is it. Inhalant addicts are also mentioned, and alcohol dependence too. This is the gist of the entire survey report, you can see. So this was a survey conducted between December 2017 and October 2018. So you can see alcohol dependence figures 5.7 crore and inhalant users, drug users, sedative users are 18 lakh and 4,60,000 children, 18 lakh adults. Cannabis dependence is 72 lakh, and the high prevalence state is also mentioned. Heroin, it is said, is the most abused opioid in India. So this is a high prevalence state for these two, these drugs, heroin. Then below you have center launches panic button on mobiles. So the government has launched a panic button feature on mobile phones for safety of women and other emergency services. So this has been launched across 16 states and Mumbai. So initiative has been jointly by Home Ministry and Women and Child Development Ministry. So after 3 years, it was announced, after the initiative was announced, now it has been made. Made mandatory as such. The requirement, there is a mandatory requirement in phones that through a gazette notification, this has been done, that a safety feature has to be there in the phones. So this is the emergency number 112 which will be provided. So this is there, a user can dial 112 from any phone. Also for a smartphone, if the power button is pressed thrice in quick succession, and for a basic or feature phone, if you long press 5 or 9 on the keypad, then also it functions as the same as sending the panic signal. So this you can see, when the panic button is pressed, five calls will be made to emergency number 112. So this is their geolocation, call log will be taken of the victim, and you know, this will be sent to the police officials at the state, district and local level. Also, you should know that this panic button facility, which is also known as emergency response support system, so this is being supported under the Nirbhaya fund for safety of women. On the editorial page, the first editorial is interim bailout. So this is regarding RBI's interim surplus, which has been transferred to the government. So this is system of sharing RBI surpluses with the center. It is said this should be quickly institutionalized. And second is clean power. So this is regarding a viable financial mechanism, which it is said should be evolved to remove pollutants in power plants. This is it. And the lead article is the importance of being human. So opposition parties, it says, must make a new anti-torture legislation part of the common program. This is a suggestion given. And this is Saudi India Pakistan triangle. So Pakistan Crown Prince is on a visit to India. He visited Pakistan too. So this article talks of how New Delhi should not be overly optimistic about prying Riyadh away from Islamabad. Then there's an interview with a former diplomat. Then on page 11, you have Fiji to maintain China-India balance. So both China and India are important partners for Fiji, the island nation. So it says we'll continue to strengthen ties with both the nations. So it's a balancing act for it. There are infrastructure projects in Fiji, which are China-led. So here you can see. These are China-led transborder infrastructure projects, which are part of the Belt and Road Initiative, in which Fiji is participating. So that is China's Belt and Road Initiative in Fiji. And with respect to India and Fiji, we have a defense agreement of 2017, which aims to deepen cooperation in maritime security and also provide training for Fiji troops. So India Fiji cooperation also continues, while China continues with its debt diplomacy, as it is here, that it is investing in infrastructure, which is a debt which Fiji will have to pay back. So this process has also attracted criticism too. But then Fiji wants to continue with the investments which China has done. It says we do not want to throw the baby out with the bathwater. So if there's something wrong, then we'll have to remove it, but we can't allow that infrastructure projects also do not take place. So every country which takes debt from China, of course, will have to be cautious about it too. So this is regarding the issue. So there have been MOUs signed also, which are proposed to be signed to strengthen bilateral ties between India and Fiji. So this is on sugar industry, agriculture, tourism, and also climate change initiatives. There's collaboration between India and Fiji on climate change initiatives. So creating awareness of climate change. So this is also there. So island nations would be worst affected because of climate change and sea level rise. So they are very proactive on this. On international page, you have this coverage on the contenders for presidential elections. These are from the Democratic Party. So there are two parties, Democrats and Republicans in USA. So these are Democrats presidential candidates. Then this is 16 US states sue Trump over border wall emergency. So emergency which has been announced in USA by President Donald Trump at the border. So 16 US states have sued him. They warn of a constitutional crisis too. Then on business page, the important news items are new angel tax rules provide relief to eligible startups. So this is regarding new rules pertaining to angel tax, which will exempt registered startups from it. So this is regarding angel tax. You should know what is angel tax too. It is applicable on unlisted companies that have raised capital through sale of shares at a value above their fair market value. So angel investors are there who invest in these startups. So the excess capital which they have raised, so this is considered as income and is taxed accordingly at the rate of angel tax. So the announcements which have been made recently because of criticism to this angel tax, because it makes foreign investments in startups unattractive, foreign as well as domestic. So what has been done is that it is said now investment of up to rupees 25 crore in an eligible company will be exempted from angel tax. And other provisions have also been added, like investments made by listed company of a net worth of at least 100 crore or a turnover of at least 250 crore would also be exempt from angel tax. Investments made by non-residents will also be exempt. So these are the new provisions which have been notified now, so that the burden of angel tax can be reduced for eligible startup firms. So also a startup firm will be one which is incorporated for less than 10 years. Earlier it was 7 years, now it has been extended to 10 years. And the turnover, it says it should not exceed 100 crore over that period. So if over 10 years it remains, turnover remains less than 100 crore rupees, then it is a startup. Then below you have GST Council to discuss realty rates. So GST Council will meet via video conferencing and will discuss key issues such as possible reduction of GST rates on real estate sector and ways to increase the tax collection. And here you have Cabinet approves phase 2 of rooftop solar program. So the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved phase 2 of grid connected rooftop solar program. So it aims to achieve a cumulative capacity of 40,000 megawatts from rooftop solar projects by 2022. So it could be providing incentives, you can see. So this phase 2 will provide assistance for residential rooftop solar installations up to 40% of rooftop systems and 20% for those with lower capacity. So capacity with higher capacity, that is lower capacity would be provided 40% assist financial assistance up to 40%. That is up to 3 kilowatts, and for capacity 3 kilowatts to 10 kilowatts, the financial assistance provided by the central government for such rooftop installations would be 20%. So this is there. So it says the second phase will also focus on increasing the involvement of DISCOMs, distribution companies. Also, the cabinet has approved launching of Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Utthan Mahabhiyan. So this is aimed at providing financial and water security to farmers. So through this scheme, farmers will be given financial assistance to set up solar panels on their unused or fallow land. So this is also another scheme which has been announced. Then on the last page, you have New Universe Map unveils 3 lakh more galaxies. So this is LOFA telescope which has detected light sources that optical instruments cannot find. So the universe is a lot bigger than what we understand. So LOFAR, it is low frequency array telescope. So this is located in Netherlands to pick up traces or jets of ancient radiations produced when galaxies merge. So this has detected these sources of light. And the last news is Aussie mammal, the first climate change extinction. So this is regarding this mammal from Australia, that is Bramble K. melomys. So this is said to be the first officially declared mammal which has been declared extinct, so because of human-induced climate change. So this is rat-like mammal, a rodent, Great Barrier Reef rodent from Australia, which has been officially declared extinct. First mammal to be declared so. So these are the important news items. Thank you. You can also visit our website asia.com. In the current affairs section, your monthly compilations are available, and also daily compilations are made available. You can access them. That is it. Also, there's a detailed current affairs video which has been uploaded yesterday. That is a sample video. It's a separate course in which detailed current affairs coverage is done. So the details of that course is provided here. Thank you.